Just so you know, I have some validity. Like, I know what I'm talking about. Your outline is basically a mini paper. I am a graduating senior, so I never have to write a paper again. And your paper is done. Count 1, 2, 3. And don't you stop the music, get into it. Won't you dance with me? Find a place and lose it. You can do it. Won't you dance with me? Move your downtown, we let go. Sunset high and I'm pretty low. Hey y'all, what is up? It is Marissa, Nicole, and welcome back to my channel. Some of you may know me as My Drifting Desk, where I help you conquer college, and that's exactly what I'm gonna do today, because y'all have been asking me how I write my papers in college for so long now. I don't know if I'm just like a good like bullshit, but writing papers is something that comes so easily to me. They don't stress me out at all. I would much rather have a final paper than a final exam. I think I'm a really good writer. I mean, obviously I started my channel off as like a blog, so in general I feel like I'm a good writer, but I don't know, like I usually do really well on my papers. And so I wanted to share with you guys, I guess, like my steps for writing a paper. We're doing this very informal because normally I do these sit down videos and I like have my camera up on a tripod and we're looking all nice, but you know, I really don't feel like doing that right now. I'm just feeling more chill and I'm just gonna lay in my bed and show you on my laptop what I do to write my papers, basically. Okay, so we're gonna rewind. Back in like November, December, I had a vlog on it where I was like writing a paper and everything, and that's when y'all started asking me basically how I do write papers, because I was kind of venting to you guys in the vlog about how it was due the next day, and it was an 8-page paper, and then basically I time-lapsed you guys, and I showed that I did it in like 2 hours, and I was done. And then my final grade in that paper, let me just tell you guys that. Just so you know, I have some validity. Like, I know what I'm talking about. So for this class, in general, there was only 4 things that we turned in, each of them worth 25 points, so basically like 25% of your grade. But the paper itself was only worth 25 points, and I got a 24.5 on it. I'm gonna tell you how we did this, okay? And even to preface this video before I start writing this paper, the reason why I feel like I'm good at like bullshitting my way through a paper is because I put in a lot of the work at the time. So like during the semester, I'm putting 110% in. I never miss class. I take extensive notes. I study my notes when I'm done. Like I do all of the work when I need to, so that way at the end, I'm not trying to teach myself everything and to take an exam. That's the worst way to do this. But I guess the first thing that I do when I'm writing papers is definitely to look over the assignment. Duh. You guys might think that's like obvious, but I'm gonna show you what I mean. So this is the assignment, or like the rubric, whatever that my professor gave us for the paper. Now when I'm reading this through, I'm going to highlight for you guys some of the key stuff that I take note of before I start writing this paper. First thing I'm going to highlight is what the paper is actually about. Duh. So the red at the top is basically what my paper is about. It's a paper that reflects a specific engagement with a body of work produced by a Black woman, femme, or gender non-binary person, or prominently featuring Black women, femme, or gender non-binary persons. And also for some background, this is the paper that I was writing last semester, because I don't have another paper that I'm writing yet this semester, so I can't write one real time for you guys, unfortunately, so I'm just gonna kind of go over what I did last semester. I'm also gonna highlight a different color, other important information, and that body of work must clearly convey how the selected body of work illustrates how and why power and politics matter. So that's, again, the core principle of the paper. And then my professor is really easy, at least for this class, but most of them will always give you areas like this where it has like questions that you should be answering throughout the paper. That is the most important part for me and my paper writing strategy, or I guess like protocol, these questions. So these are all so important. Now I knew I wanted to film a video on this when I was writing this paper, so I actually screenshotted a lot of my work that I was doing during the paper writing process so I could like pop it up here, which would be perfect. So basically what I do is take all of these core questions. It's easy because they're all together and she even put them underneath the heading, but normally they'd be within the rubric somehow and I would highlight them. But picking out what the paper needs to be about is the most important thing. And then other key elements about the paper that are important. So my paper has to be that red title at the beginning, and it must clearly convey basically that last blue thing. While it's doing that, it has to answer all these core questions that my professor wants me to answer. So what I do, as you'll see here, is basically I start an outline. And you can do this on paper, you can do this on the computer, whatever makes sense to you, whatever's easier for you. But I create an outline online because it's easier for me, because I know I'm gonna be typing my paper anyways. And in this outline, basically, every little dash is a different paragraph. So of course, I'm gonna start out with an introduction. And then each paragraph is gonna be answering a different question that my professor wants me to answer. Sorry, that was my mom. So as you can see, I have my intro paragraph, and then I'm gonna talk about what the body work is that I chose and just talk about it. I need to give background about the body of work. That's not something that she specifically asked for, but for me, makes sense for the flow of the paper. Then I'm gonna talk about the core elements of the body of work that are pertinent to this paper. So what exactly about this body of work that I have chosen is important and can't answer all of these things. That's kind of, to me, like a summary paragraph that is like, this is what we're going to talk about, but much better than like in elementary school when you wrote those little like hamburger style introductions. And then we're gonna answer the questions, is how does this body work engage with Black Black women and representation, how is Black womanhood articulated, depicted, and conceptualized in this body of work, and then how this body of work wrestles with the social, historical, cultural construction of Black womanhood, and then the last paragraph is my wrap-up and conclusion. So if I follow this outline, I'm going to have the paper be written on something that I'm supposed to be writing about. I'm going to describe this body of work so my professor knows what the hell I'm talking about, and I'm going to answer all the questions that she wants me to answer with this outline. That is how I like to start my papers. My next step is to either, depending on the kind of paper, if it's a research paper, the next step that I'm going to do is basically go through all of my sources that I've chosen. So if the topic of the paper is how bees are important to the environment and people and the way the world works, etc., following the parameters, if I need like four different sources, I'm going to go find those four sources first, and then I'm going to pull important information from those four sources that answers the questions that I have. So those different paragraphs that I have are the questions that I've chosen, pulling out all of that information. So for example, this is what I screenshotted when I was writing my paper, that under the intro paragraph, I wrote down some of the things that I wanted to talk about, which was what I chose to do my paper on, which was the Savage X Fenty fashion show. And it was created by Rihanna. What it is, it's a lingerie line. It was launched on May 11th. And then the next paragraph was describing the body of work and the person who created it. So I was pulling stuff from my sources online and just from watching the fashion show, which of course is its own source. And as you can see, there's like hyperlinks, those two hyperlinks there. I'm making sure that I link back to where I got this information from. And this is important for the actual paper writing, because most papers that you do in college, you are going to have to put down your sources, you know, cite your sources and do some sort of citation in your papers, whether it's APA, MLA, footnotes, I don't, depending on what your professor wants, somehow you're gonna have to cite your sources because of plagiarism. So to me, I like to stay organized, and as I'm picking out what I wanna talk about, I'm automatically linking where that came from, because I'm gonna need that later when I use it in the paper to cite it correctly. So that's what the links are. If there's information with no links next to it, that's just what I got from the Fendi X Savage fashion show itself from watching it. And to me, this is gonna be the most time consuming part, is going through all of your sources, reading all of the things, doing all of your research, whatever you need to use to write your paper. That's gonna be the longest part, is reading it all and picking out what's important. And then for me, the most important, but still part of the time consuming part, is placing that bit of information in the correct spot. The last bullet point here says, after being unable to find the right color nude underwear to wear under her naked dress in 2014, Rihanna wanted to offer her full range of nudes herself. For example, that is going to go under how the body of work engages with Black women and representation. So I'm putting that under the correct paragraph or heading, because that's where it belongs. So again, I'm organizing my thoughts as I'm picking stuff out, because you're kind of knocking two birds out with one stone. If you're just like reading stuff and highlighting and be like, oh yeah, I'm gonna use that, and then it comes time to write the paper and you're like, okay, how am I gonna use that? Where do I need to put it? What makes the most sense? Where do I organize it? I just organize it as I'm finding the information, and that saves time for me, and it just helps me make sense of what I'm finding. Sorry, I keep moving, but basically after I pick out all the information that I need to write my paper, I've organized it in my outline, putting it underneath the heading or in the correct paragraph that I want it to be. For me, that's basically my paper. Like when I do this step, of course I only screenshotted it. I wish I still had it to actually show you guys, but this step itself, when I'm like building my outline itself was, I wanna say, 3 pages single spaced. So when you double space that, that usually turns into about 6 pages. So even just my outline itself is 6 out of the 8 pages that I need to write, because I am putting in all the information that I can find, what is important, what is needed, I'm organizing it. Your outline is basically a mini paper. And then for me, basically I open up a new paper I'm going to start writing. I use the outline to write it. I know exactly the order that I'm gonna go in. I know what information needs to go in it. The outline is more of just like quick bullet points, so I need to make it more wordy, of course, and things that make sense, or putting in more examples, or just like obviously putting it together in a well-written paper, basically. Now a trick for me is, as I am completing a bullet point or a heading or whatever, once I put that bit of information in the paper somewhere, I will go back to my outline and highlight it yellow, as you can see here. So that way I see what has already been used so I don't use it again. And this way I can also see my paper like dwindling. So if I'm only at page 5 and I can tell this is all I have left, I'm like, ooh, I'm not gonna be able to stretch this out for 4 more pages. I need to go back and find more information. And this is more so just an organizational tip. I just do this so it helps me know what I've already used in the paper. And of course, my outline can change. While I'm writing the paper, things may move around, or I may figure out that this works better in this paragraph and I move it. I'll move it in the outline as well, just so I can keep my thoughts organized. But don't think that your outline is like stuck, like you have to do that. My stuff changes all the time. It's just a starting point for me that helps me write a paper. And so eventually, when you're finished writing your paper, your stuff will look like this, which is basically everything is highlighted and your paper is done. And then here is my final paper. I'm just gonna like scroll through it for you guys. If you guys wanna like pause as I'm scrolling to, I guess, read it for whatever reason, you can. But this is what my final paper ended up coming out as. My professor only had us do citations at the bottom, so footnotes, so that's where you guys see that. I have just my links and simple citations. She didn't have us do like a whole works cited at the end, which was great, and it saved a lot of time as well. But as you can see, I just was able to turn my outline into a full paper. I finished it in probably like 2 or 3 hours. Now I will say this specific paper is easy for me to write about rather than a research paper, but I have written research papers like that. I'm a psychology major, we do a lot of research, and so this paper is just the only one that I have like a paper trail and like proof of for me to show you guys how I write my papers, so that's why I'm using this as the example. But I've used my system for every paper I've written, all of college, research papers, hardcore papers, long papers, short papers, whatever I need to write, I'm using this system, and it's never failed me, and it's super easy to stay organized and to get it done in a timely manner, at least for me. So I'm hoping that was helpful for you. I know you guys have really wanted a look into my paper writing system. The system itself is relatively easy. Again, I feel like it's easy for me because I put the work in all through the semester, so when a final paper comes up and when a final exam comes up, I'm not struggling to do all of the assignments, learn all the material, find all the research stuff, read all of this, and write a paper on something I know nothing about. If you have personal tips and tricks that you use to write your own papers, let me know down below in the comments. Help each other out. I am a graduating senior, so I never have to write a paper again, at least in college, undergrad. But all of you guys are here because you want to know how to write a paper, so help each other out in the comments down below. Hopefully somebody has posted something else that may help you if this system does not help you. Everybody is different, everybody learns differently and writes differently, so I know that my system isn't gonna work for everybody, but I'm hoping that it might help someone out there. If you like this video or you learned something new, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe down below, turn on your post notifications, and follow me over on Instagram. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!